1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Oh my God. I really don't think I would be able to complete all of this book. Namaste guys and welcome back to my channel. I am Divya and I make videos book related, so make sure to like, comment, share as much as you can and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. So now, as the title says, I am going to be sharing with you my TBR for Disney Readathon, and I'm already scared of seeing all of those books for my TBR as I don't even read a single book for a month. So reading 12 books for a month is really a challenge for me. So without any further ado, let's see what are the books that I'm planning to read for this readathon. So as I am leader of these two teams, that is Little Mermaid and Hercules, I have to actually go through both of their TBRs and try to read them. I don't even know that I'm going to complete these two teams. I don't even know if I'm going to complete a single team. So I'm not even caring about making a TBR for other two teams that are leaded by Ellie. So yeah, that's not going to happen. So I'm not going to make a TBR for them. So I'm going to first share with you my TBR from The Little Mermaid. So the first from for The Little Mermaid is Ariel. Read a book with Singer as a main character. So if you have already watched my announcement video, I've recommended you this book, that is Sing You Home by Jodi Picoult. That book was my first choice for that this readathon, but then after going through my shelf, I found this book, that is The Surface Breaks by Louis O'Neill. So I thought maybe I should read this book, as this is a Little Mermaid retelling, and as Little Mermaid is there, she's of course going to sing. So this book is about a female character, that is Gia. I really don't know how to pronounce the name. That's the spelling, G-A-I-A. So if you know, make sure to comment in the comment section. So a female lead, Gia, is a little mermaid who has this over-controlling father who doesn't let her to go to the surface. So when she finally goes to the surface and there she meets this boy, what she has to sacrifice? How and when will she regain her voice? So this is seriously like whole plot screams Little Mermaid. So of course I think this is going to be a proper retelling of Little Mermaid, but there's also this sticker here which says that this contains adult themes and maybe not appropriate for young readers. So this is a new adult book. Now the second prompt is Prince Eric, read a book by your favorite author. So I'm going to read this book, that is Star Daughter by Shweta Thakral. I have actually was already planning to read this book for, I'm actually part of this tour that is from the Hear the Voices Again. And I'm also like, I'm already making a vlog for this, going to make this vlog for this book. So yeah, why not just read this book for this prompt also. So the Star Daughter is about the daughter of the star and a model, Shweta, who used to live with her father, that is a model. But when a flare of starlight injures her father, she needs a real star who can help her to save her father. So a real star like her mother. So she goes on this journey to find this real stars to save her father. So again, I have not read this book, so this is all I can tell. So now the third prompt is Flounder. Read a book with great friendship. So I really don't have many books from my shelf that screams great friendship, but here I am going to read this book, that is The Raven Boys by Maggie Steph Better. And after reading the blurb, I find it quite romance kind of book and quite similar to Hana Yoritango Walls Over Flower, but let's see, it has a magic intake in it. So it's like if Blue haven't been told that she kissed a girl, he could die, but when she entered the high school and she meets this boys that are known as Raven Boys, her life is going to change. She is going to like be thrown in this world with magic and crows. So yeah, so this book is about that, and this year she will fall in love. So I've seen this thing and I've actually gone through your Discord chat, and some of you recommended that there's a great friendship in this book, so I just pick up this book. So now the fourth prompt is, Ursula, read a book in which character changes their appearance often. So as I've recommended a book in my previous announcement video, I'm going to read this book, that is Again Shiva by, again, the author Maggie Stiefvater. Sorry if I pronounce the name wrong, surname wrong actually. So this book is kind of a werewolf romance book, and it's about a local boy that is killed by wolves, and Grace's small town becomes a place of fear and suspicion. But Grace can't help being fascinated by the pack and by one yellow-eyed wolf in particular. There's something about him, something almost human. So fun thing, I bought this book, not this book, the whole series is there up on the topmost shelf. I bought this whole series mainly because of the cover page. I didn't even know what this was about. I got to know about this after I bought and actually gone through all the books that I bought. So I'm lucky enough that I got this book and the prompt is there that I made without even thinking. So yeah, I'm going to read this book. So the last prompt is by Sebastian, and he wants you to read the group book. But like most of you, I'm actually trying to get the hold of the group book, but I can't cause it's not available in India right now in the paperback. It's not also available for hardback, and if it is available for even Kindle, it's really expensive. Things are like that. I'm actually trying to get at least ebook for this, but the ebooks cost like a paperback. So yeah, let's see. And the thing is also that being in a contaminated area, most of the time they are not shipping in my area, so I have to just go with the digital copy only. So if I got it, I'll read it and discuss with you guys. So now the second team for which I have already planned my TBR is for Hercules. And the first prompt for the Hercules by Hercules himself, read a book by a strong male character. For this, I have chosen this book, that is Six of Crows by Leigh Bardugo. So this book is, you all know what is this book, prodigy, criminal prodigy caste breaker who is offered the wealth beyond his dream and is going to get that at any cost. So I really don't know much about Leigh Bardugo's world, but some of you like recommended me and like suggested me to read the season, Shadowbone season first. And I don't even know what I'm saying. What's the name of that series? Was I think Shadow and Bone. I guess that's the name of the series. If I'll just put the caption here if I remember the name. So yeah, that series first, to just go through the world building in this book. But I don't even own that book right now, and it's just not an option to buy this book and wait for that to read. So I'm hoping to complete this book. And as for the strong male character, I think Castbreaker is strong enough to for this prompt. So now the second prompt is from Megara, and she wants you to read a book with a female lead or female character who is damsel in distress, but no damsel in distress. For this book, I'm going to read The Owl Killer's novel of the Dark Age by Karen Maitland. So this book is about a religious group of women who are ill and advisedly settles outside the village, and they awaken dangerous jealousies. So now, why do their crops succeed, and why not the crops of the villagers succeed? And how do their characters survive the plague? Are they concealing a holy relic that protects them from other harms? So the owl masters scribe witchcraft and sharpens their talents. As torment and hellfire rain down, the women must take a stand to stop this darkness from spreading its evil across the land. Sorry, I didn't know how to explain this whole thing without even reading the blurb. So I just read the blurb, and this is what this is about. So there's this religious women who are just settling outside the village, and because they are not getting affected by the plague and their crops are succeeding, people are saying that they are witches, they are do witchcraft, but that's not the case. So yes, they are going to try to do something to stop them to go down the hell. So I choose this book for this whole kind of for this prompt mainly because as they are a religious woman and they are not prone to violence, and they are like some like what they are silent and go with God. So when the things crisis like this happens, they are going to stand up for themselves, and they are also going to stand up for others to make them not go down the hell. So now for the next prompt is from Hates, and he wants you to read a book that is dark, mystery or fantasy. So I found this book that is dark, mysterious book, and I don't know if this holds some magical or fantasy element or not, but this book is The Miniaturist by Jesse Burton. So this book is about an 18-year-old Nella Ortman who arrives at Amsterdam mansion to start a new life with her husband Johannes Brand. So he offers her as a wedding present a cabinet sized replica of their home, and it has been furnished by an elusive miniaturist whose tiny creations ring eerily true. So now the thing is that the fate of their whole family, their whole mansion is in the hands of that miniaturist. So I've read quite a few reviews about this book, that how this book is eerily spooky and kind of gives you goosebumps, and it's actually a mystery, a dark mystery kind of thing. So yeah, I'm going to read this book for this prompt. So now the next prompt is for Sisters of Fate, and that is, you need to read a book with three witches in it or just a witch in it. So I couldn't find exactly which book from my shelf. There are many books out there, believe me, but just from my shelf. So I just found this book, that is Caraval by Stephanie Garber, and this book doesn't have exactly a witch that is going to be all like for whole length of the book, but she is going to make a tiny appearance in this book. So I'm going to read this book for that. So this book is about a infamous master legend haunts once a year. A caravel opens only for those who are invited. So it is a week-long game is on legends glittering Isla de los Cienos, where the winding streets are an elaborate snow-covered maze, and the people are never who they are. So the visitors there at midnight becomes the players, and they play for just being granted one wish from them. So yeah, but this game holds again some dangerous thing and everything. So I've actually heard so many good things about this, but yet again, not very good things about this book also. So as for this book has also mixed reviews, you can read this book for some other prompt also, if you got what I'm saying, some other team. So yeah, I'm going to read this book for this prompt, that is for Sisters of Fate. It's going to have a little tiny bit of witch appearance, but there is a witch in it. So I'm going to read that. Now the last prompt is by Phil, and he wants us to read a group book. So a group book is Stranger Dreamer by Liane Taylor. Again, I don't own that book, and again that book cost it on Amazon, and again Kindle also cost so much. I don't even know, as soon as the pandemic started, the prices of the books, even the Kindle prices, have just spiked up, and I couldn't even get the Kindle copies right now. So I'll try to get the Kindle copy or try to read something close to that book, so if I could find and discuss with you all. So these were all the prompts, and again the special abilities I've already discussed, but again I'm going to discuss with you, and I'm sorry again, forgot to discuss Little Mermaid's special ability, which is King Triton has restored you with the lightning power, and you can start reading from any team without according going to map. But once you have started, you can't look back. If you have started from Hercules, you have to go according to map from Hercules. If you have started from Little Mermaid, just go from Little Mermaid. You can start from any team, but you can't go back. You have to follow the circle to go back. And yet again, it's not necessary for you to read every team's prompt. You can skip a team. You only need to read the prompts, all the prompts of your team. And now as for the Hercules special abilities that are given by 5 muses, you can jump to another team prompt if you don't like your team prompt. Like if you're not liking the Hercules team prompt, you can just jump to Beauty and the Beast, you can jump to Princess and the Frog, you can jump to Little Mermaid and start from there. But yet again, once you have started there, you can't go back. You have to follow the map, go in the circle, and then come again to Hercules if you want to read the Hercules. And also I'm going to tell you this again, if you do not use these abilities, nothing's going to change. You are going to get 40 points, you're not going to lose anything. There will be no DNFs, but if you DNF a book, you are only going to lose a point, that is 10 points, 20 points, whatever book that you are DNFing. you can change prompts, you can change TBRs, you can change your, like, double up books, you can swap books for other team's prompts, but that does not apply for your own team. If I am Little Mermaid, that does not apply for my team, Little Mermaid. But I can do that, swapping, double upping a prompt, changing my TBRs for Beauty and the Beast, for other teams, Princess and the Frog, as Hercules is also my team, I can't do that for also. So this was for all for my TBR for the whole team, a very ambitious TBR that I have ever made. So wish me luck, and if you have already, your TBRs are up, make sure to come in the comment section, make sure to tag us on the Twitter, on Instagram. We are going to share it further and feature you with the best TBR. So goodbye till the next video.